In May 1942, land, which included part of Twyford Forest, located southeast of the village of Colsterworth in Lincolnshire, was requisitioned for the construction of a satellite airfield for RAF Grantham in No. 7 Group Bomber Command. Construction of the airfield began at the end of the year and involved the closure of one road. It was, however, immediately allocated to the USAAF because of the urgent need of airfields for the rapid build-up of the American Air Force. Three standard concrete and tarmac runways were constructed, the main at 2,000 yards and the subsidiaries at 1,400 yards in length. 50 spectacle-type dispersals were built in accordance with USAAF specifications, with most on short peri-track stubs because of terrain restrictions. Two T2 hangars were constructed, one on the technical site to the southeast of the airfield and the other off the northwest perimeter track. Later, six Butler hangars were also provided. The Butler hangar had rigid box section girders over a canvas cladding to give a wide 40-foot span. They were designed and built by the Butler Manufacturing Company of Kansas, USA, and were erected on the site by an engineer aviation battalion to accommodate the engineering work. A watch office for all commands to plan 12779-41 with medium windows to plan 343-43 was constructed. The bomb stores were located to the northeast of the airfield. The communal and accommodation sites were dispersed to the south around Honeypot Lane, and accommodation was built for 97 RAF officers and 1,857 other ranks, with, in addition, WAF accommodation for 10 officers and 205 other ranks. The airfield opened in the autumn of 1943 as RAF North Witham, and in December became USAAF Station 479, an air depot. This is properly termed the first tactical air depot of the first advanced air depot area. This depot appears to have comprised the 29th and 33rd air depot groups, which in turn comprised the 10th, 49th, 78th, 82nd, 100th, 317th and 318th service groups. These looked after maintenance of Douglas C-47 and C-53 Skytrain transports, plus Hadrian and Horsa gliders. Two mobile repair and reclamation squadrons were based at North Witham in 1944. These were the 44th from January and the 27th from the 3rd of April. The 9th Troop Carrier Command's Pathfinder School arrived from RAF Cottesmore in March with 7 C-47s equipped with G-radar for accurate navigation and began training with the 82nd and 101st Divisions. On the 5th of June 1944, 20 of North Witham's C-47s departed at 2200 hours to fly the first airborne operation of the day, dropping 200 men as an advance party who had set up visual aids and a Eureka ground-based radar device. The following C-47s in the main force were equipped with Rebecca receivers, which picked up the Eureka signal, thereby accurately guiding the main body of airborne troops to the drop zone. The mission was a success, and only one aircraft was lost, having been shot down. Training continued at North Witham until the unit moved to Chelgrove in Oxfordshire on the 10th to the 14th of September, and was renamed as the Pathfinder Group Provisional. After the 82nd and 101st Divisions had departed, the Pathfinder School continued to train, amongst others, the Polish Airborne Brigade. The Pathfinder Group flew from North Witham for Operation Market Garden between the 17th and 25th of September. Meanwhile, the North Witham Depot was renamed as the 9th Troop Carrier Service Wing Provisional, and C-47 maintenance continued, but on an ever-reducing scale. In May 1945, Station 479 closed and was transferred back to the RAF and was almost immediately used by No. 100 MU at RAF South Witham as an expansive bomb dump on the Hardstandings and Runways. No. 16 maintenance unit formed on the 1st of June as an equipment supply depot, a role which continued until the early 1950s. No. 259 maintenance unit formed on the 1st of July 1945 as an equipment disposal depot, and although it moved its main site to Peterborough in April 1946, it retained the use of North Witham until the 31st of August 1948. From the 1st of October 1945 to the 5th of January 1946, North Witham hosted No. 4 RAF Regiment Depot. This depot existed to stream RAF Regiment personnel returning from overseas into categories for early release, whilst also training new recruits, and in addition ran field training courses. By April 1946, No. 3 RAF Regiment Depot at RAF Falkingham was taking over these roles, and No. 4 Depot was closed. By 1956, RAF North Witham was surplus to RAF requirements and was placed on care and maintenance, until finally sold off in 1960. The Forestry Commission then extended Twyford Wood to cover the airfield site, preserving much of the wartime layout. Nicholas Udall wrote on the now-defunct old airfield's website that he lived in Colsterworth and had visited the woods and the derelict control tower at around 9 p.m. on the 2nd of August 2007. At the tower, he spent some time speaking to a man in the doorway who was telling him that he had been bringing in aircraft but that it was now safe to walk onto the runway. As Nicholas's girlfriend arrived with her young son, the man said he had to go and do a few checks. He turned and walked up the steps inside the control tower. Strangely, they could not hear any footsteps in the tower after he had entered. And, when they looked, there was nobody inside the building. David wrote to me recently and enclosed the following information. David works in one of the new buildings on the former north camp of the airfield, near the new Colsterworth roundabout on the A1. He wrote that he has heard the odd account of pottery cups and plates being broken on the floor while nobody has been near them. He adds that in the past few weeks, while he has been in the main area talking to the girls who work there, he has caught figures in the corner of his eye. But when he mentioned this to the girls, saying, "Where's that person gone?" they always replied that they never saw anybody. This naturally has David wondering, was there someone or something there? Or is there some natural reason for what he has seen? In the 1970s, there was a junction across the A1 where the new roundabout was built, and there were quite a few people killed at this junction in road accidents. David wondered whether these accidents had been the cause of a spirit being unsettled and moving and breaking stuff. As a final note, the building is always cold even with the heaters on, but on one night in January this year, it was freezing outside, and it was strangely and unusually warm inside. The following morning, however, when staff arrived for work, it was back to its usual temperature.